thank you for purchasing the Araby Wi-Fi Cam 8C Pro. The 8C Pro is a Wi-Fi camera, not a 4G camera, and only supports connecting to a 2.4 GHz network. In this video, I'll go over the two different ways that you can set up your camera. One way involves hooking your camera up to your Wi-Fi network by scanning a QR code within the app. The other way to connect to the camera involves connecting to its own hotspot. That way is a bit more limited because it requires that you be close enough to the camera itself in order to access it, whereas if you hook the camera up to a network, you can access the camera as long as your phone has a network it can access. So without further ado, let's get started. Before you begin, it's a good practice to make sure that your camera is charged up a bit to avoid any issues with the process. Anything over 40% should be more than enough charge. When you're ready, head on over to your smart device's app store and download the HIDV Cam app from either the Google Play Store or the Apple App Store. You can also scan the QR code in the instruction manual to take you there directly. Once the app has been installed and opened, the app will prompt you to allow certain permissions so that everything functions properly. Simply confirm the permissions to continue. Then you'll be prompted to sign into or register an account with the app. Go ahead and use one of the social media icons to sign in, or use an email of yours to continue creating an account. Once you've signed into the app, it should now show you the button to press in order to add a device. Hit the plus sign at the top right corner as instructed. There are two buttons, Add Device by Scanning Code and Add Device by Camera's Hotspot on that next screen. There are two ways to get the camera hooked up to a network. Let's try them one by one. Let's try the first way, Add Device by Scanning Code. So click that button. The app will now instruct you to power on the device. Do that now and take note of the blue flashing light on the front side of the camera. Once it begins flashing, hit Next on the app. Now locate the reset button on the back of the camera located just above the memory card slot and to the right of the letters TF. This is a tiny button. Go ahead and hold the button in for about 6 seconds until the camera beeps at you and goes back to flashing a blue light. Once the camera is flashing the blue light, you may hit the next button in the app. And be sure to allow any permissions it asks for, such as location, storage, or microphone, in order to get the camera working properly. On this screen, you should choose your 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi network if you wish to connect it to a network. Once chosen, you can hit the back button to return to the previous screen. Now, be sure to set the Wi-Fi password in the field below the network name, and when you're done, tap the next button to continue. The next screen is a confirmation screen. If the Wi-Fi name and password is correct, hit confirm. Now the app will display a QR code on the screen. Go ahead and take the camera and hold it close to the screen so it can read the QR code. Then very slowly back the camera away from the QR code until the camera beeps and the app confirms the connection. Once the beep happens from the camera, click next and it will begin a countdown to finish the setup. The app will now show a screen that allows you to name your device. Do that now and tap confirm at the bottom. It should now say that the device has been added successfully and it will instruct you to test the Wi-Fi signal strength for a better user experience. Tap confirm to continue. For this part, you'll want to put the camera in a location where you wish to install it and keep your phone close to the camera as well. When you're ready, tap next. You should now get a readout of the signal strength and a preview live stream from the camera there as well on the screen. If there's an issue with this step, you may need to install the camera closer to the Wi-Fi router. Otherwise, tap Completed to finish the process. Congratulations! Now you should see a screen with all the functions of the camera. Now go ahead and try the second way. Add device by camera's hotspot. Hit the plus sign at the top right corner of the app. Click on the button, Add Devices by Camera's Hotspot. The app will now instruct you to power on the device. So do that now and take note of the blue flashing light on the front side of the camera. Once it begins flashing, hit Next on the app. Now locate the reset button on the back of the camera located just above the memory card slot and to the right of the letters TF. This is a tiny button, so go ahead and hold the button in for about 6 seconds until the camera beeps at you and goes back to flashing a blue light. Once the camera is flashing the blue light, you may hit the next button on the app. On this screen, you should choose your 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi network if you wish to connect it to a network. Once chosen, you can hit the back button to return to the previous screen. Now, be sure your correct 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi is chosen in this menu, and set the Wi-Fi password in the field below the network name. Now tap Next to continue. The next screen is a confirmation screen. If the Wi-Fi name and password is correct, hit Confirm. On this screen, hit Connect Device Access Point, and choose the hotspot of the camera starting with IPC from the list. You may get an audio prompt saying that a connection was successfully made. Now, once you've picked the camera's Wi-Fi hotspot starting with IPC, you can hit the back button to return to the previous screen. Now it will start a countdown. If at any point you get an error about a Wi-Fi mismatch or not being connected to the Wi-Fi that you chose a step before, go ahead and manually connect to your chosen 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi connection during the countdown and things should go smoothly. If at any point you get a message saying you have no internet on this connection, always choose the option to stay connected to that network. This is normal and only means that your phone is switching from the camera's Wi-Fi to the home Wi-Fi, and this error may come up in the process. It's normal. Simply ignoring it may cause your smartphone to switch to another working Wi-Fi, like a 5 GHz Wi-Fi, and this will not work. So be sure you're connected to your 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi connection, or remaining to stay connected to your 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi connection if you get these warning messages anytime throughout this entire setup process. It may be beneficial to go into your Wi-Fi settings and temporarily forget the connection to any other Wi-Fi networks it has access to so that the smartphone or the app do not try to reconnect to the nearest or fastest, usually 5G network, that it can connect to. After the countdown is completed, it will then show a prompt for you to bind your camera or name your device. Go ahead and work through the app's prompts here to add the camera to the app's list. It should now say that the device has been added successfully and will instruct you to test the Wi-Fi signal strength for a better user experience. So tap Confirm to continue. For this part, you'll want to put the camera in a location where you wish to install it and keep your phone close to the camera as well. And when you're ready, tap Next. You should now get a readout of the signal strength and a preview live stream from the camera there as well on the screen. If there is an issue with this step, you may need to install the camera closer to the Wi-Fi router. Otherwise, tap Completed to finish the process. Congratulations! Now you should see a screen with all the functions of the camera. Now, for those of you who want to connect to the camera and access its live feed without actually connecting it to any Wi-Fi network, here's how to do that. Simply close the HIDV Cam app completely if it's open. Then turn on your camera and reset the camera by holding the reset button for 6 seconds until it beeps. Then wait for a moment and go to the Wi-Fi settings of your phone. Now choose the camera's Wi-Fi hotspot. It should look something like IPC dash and a bunch of numbers. Choose that Wi-Fi network. And ignore the messages saying that internet may not be available, as that's normal for this procedure. Now, once you're connected to the camera's Wi-Fi hotspot, open up the HIDV Cam app again, and you should see it asking you to connect your device to a router's Wi-Fi. If you hit yes here, you will be asked to go through a similar procedure as mentioned earlier, but since we're not connecting it to a Wi-Fi with this method, you may choose no for this prompt. At this point, you should see your camera in the list on the main screen of the app, and when you hit the play button to view its stream, it will ask for a password for the camera. Go ahead and choose a password, then confirm it in the box below and tap Next. Now you should be viewing your camera's live feed with access to its functions, such as alarm sounds, night vision, voice, and so on. Now keep in mind that if you're not connecting the camera up to your 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi, you will need to be within range of the actual camera itself and the camera's own hotspot in order to access the camera in this way. Lastly, you may notice some difficulty when viewing the camera with night vision mode, if there are any objects very close to the camera's position. This is due to the infrared lamp being much like a flashlight that we cannot see with our own eyes. So if the infrared light of the camera shines onto something too close to the camera, it will appear very bright and could give you some trouble seeing what's in the distance. To avoid this, make sure the camera doesn't have anything too close to it on either side, and you should be good to go. And that wraps this one up. We hope that you enjoy your Araby Wi-Fi Cam 8C Pro. And if you have any questions or any comments at all about your device, please don't hesitate to send an email to the support team shown in the user manual included in your box, and we'll be glad to get back to you as soon as we can. Goodbye and have a good one.